In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, to whom we all have to turn back. Honorable listeners and respectable audience, you know that we have started a series of linguistics. In linguistics, we commenced the chapter that is known as Theories and Frameworks and Discourse Analysis. Yesterday, I told you that in order to be a successful analyst, you must know some frameworks and theories and discourse analysis to analyze a text in a better way. Listeners and audience, yesterday, I started a framework that is known as Aristotle Modes of Persuasion. Aristotle Modes of Persuasion is also known as rhetorical devices or persuasive strategies. The first part I defined and explained with examples, and that was ethos. Ethos refers to the trustworthiness and credibility of the speaker. Today, I'm going to teach you the next part of it, the next strategy of it, the next strategy of Aristotle Modes of Persuasion, and that is pathos. Pathos is actually generating emotional appeal among the audience. In other words, generating a state of mind among the participants by emotional appeal, that is called pathos. Pathos is used by the speaker in such a way as a persuasive strategy that the participants do something. Emotional language is a part of pathos that creates inclination and strong feelings among the audience. Listeners and audience, and pathos strategy of persuasion includes like fear, hope, free, empathy, sympathy, and rhetorical questions, and even pity. In order to clarify it with better understanding and examples, let me first of all start from hope. Listeners and audience, you know, whenever, for example, take the example of a religious scholar. Whenever a religious scholar, he is talking about good deeds, the listeners, the participants, they are listening to his speech. He says, for example, that if you do good deeds and not harming anyone, definitely, as a being a Muslim, you are doing a good deeds, you will go to paradise. So such statement is based on hope, and it is a persuasive strategies based on the strategies of Aristotle Modes of Persuasion, pathos. It means my statement is based on pathos strategies of persuasion, and it also creates hope among the participants. Because the participants, they hope that if they are doing good deeds, definitely they will go to paradise. And as I told you, that it creates emotional appeals also among the participants. Like when he say, for example, when he's talking about the prayer, that may Allah grant us success. The participant says, Amen. It means they say, oh Allah, accept our this supplication, this praise. It also includes rhetorical questions. The next example is rhetorical questions. Listeners and audience, remember that here rhetorical questions does not mean that the speaker is going to ask questions, the participants. No. Here actually rhetorical question is just for the sake of emphasis, just for the sake of inclination, and that the audience take interest. Like for example, a speaker says it, if you are not working, what do you think? If you are not working, what would be our future? So here he does not ask actually the audience to answer his question, but he says that, what do you think if you are not working? What would be our future? So these questions are not directly from the audience that they answer. It is just for the sake of inclination for the audience. And similarly, if a religious scholar, for example, he is talking about hell, that those people who are harming other, who are not, for example, passing their life, leading their lives according to the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teachings of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, definitely they will enter to hell. So it creates fear among the participants, among the audience. So this statement is also based on the Pathos strategy of persuasion. So you can apply Pathos strategies, that this statement is based on that strategy. Even gratitude is also there. For example, when you help other people or you say something, and the participant said thank you, even that thank you is based to Pathos strategies of persuasion. So listeners and audience, hope that now you know about Pathos, that what is mean by Pathos, what are the examples of Pathos, and how to apply Pathos. So how to apply Pathos strategies of persuasion? You can apply Pathos strategy of persuasion is when you see fear, hope, pray, anger in the statements of someone in written speech or in spoken speech. Hope that this topic is clear to you.